Okay, and then we're off. So welcome back, everyone, or no one, or whatever. I'm gonna play the Stanley Parable again. I learned yesterday that it is the HD remix and not the classic game. Well, I knew it was a remake, but I didn't know it was already called the HD remix. So now I think I just have only one more option left, one more choice to make before I have had all the endings. So let's get started on this. Oh, I can actually oh, that's nice. I really love my two screens now. I realized I could hook up two screens, but yesterday I found out I realized I had a TV screen still just standing around in my room, and an HD cable, HDMI cable also laying around. So I figured I might as well just hook it up on my laptop and see the results. But now I can both see the chat on one screen and the game, the full game, on the full screen game on the other, on my laptop screen. Would be easier to, would be nicer to switch them around, but I think that would be just too confusing.
This
okay.
is the story of a man named Stanley.
Let's skip this. We've already seen this the first time. Let's see. I don't know if it's gonna be. Is it harder? No, I think it's just fine. I don't know. There seems to be a bit of lag here, though. I might want to close. I'm just gonna see. Might want to close this OBS down. Oh, what? Oh, okay. I just restarted. Okay. Never mind. Doesn't really matter. Okay, I've closed OBS down, and I think that would be of effect.
How long was I sitting there? Stanley wondered to himself. Minutes? Days? Centuries? Did something crucial happen while my senses were turned? He made a note to be more careful with time from now on.
Time doesn't mean a lot in this game. So being more careful in it, with it won't really help us out here. Clocks are still ticking. That's good. Okay, so we're going
when
left.
Stanley came to a set of two open doors. He entered the door on his left.
And then next, we go into the board meeting room.
Yet there was not a single person here either.
We know.
Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office, hoping he might find an answer there.
The target demographic is teenagers. Let's sell our product to teenagers. Stock market. Using slides to assure employees that everything is okay. There's still so much in this room I haven't seen yet. Well, especially most of their slides here. But I've seen most of them. I'm not gonna bore you guys by watching at them again. So let's keep going. You have the epic broom closet.
Stanley stepped into the broom closet, but there was nothing here, so he turned around and got back on track.
Of course. Because I've already had the broom closet ending. Yay!
Coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
Yeah, I'm gonna do that, because if I go downstairs, it doesn't end well. I've noticed that yesterday. I found that out yesterday, and no, don't want to do that again. I don't want to do that again. So let's keep going, keep moving. Still happy.
Stepping into his manager's office, Stanley was once again stunned to discover not an indication of any human life. Shocked, unraveled, Stanley wondered in disbelief who orchestrated this. What dark secret was being held from him? What he could not have known was that the keypad behind the boss's desk guarded the terrible truth that his boss had been keeping from him. And so the boss had assigned it an extra secret PIN number. 2845. But of course, Stanley couldn't possibly have known this.
Probably not. I could press the right code, the correct code, and like I did last time. I don't think there's a lot of choice here. 1, 2...
Stanley just sat around twiddling his thumbs. Trying to input anything on the device was useless, since he could never possibly know that the combination was 2845.
Nope.
2845.
2845. Let's just do it.
Yet incredibly,
nothing
by
happens.
Simply pushing random
nothing
buttons
happens.
On the keypad, Stanley happened to input the correct code by sheer luck. Amazing. He stepped into the newly opened passageway.
Mm-hmm. Whee! And we're back in the elevator. So this time we're not gonna try to escape and land in the and arrive in the weird museum part of the game. We're just gonna head to the control room. Oh, there might be another choice in the control room. Gonna see if there's anything there. I know there's one choice left.
The building, Stanley realized he felt a bit peculiar. It was a stirring
of
emotion in his chest,
where you have to press one of the two buttons.
For himself,
there should be one one choice there.
Why did he feel this now, when for years
but
it had never occurred to him?
It would be awesome if there was one
would not go unanswered
for
long.
More choices to make. So let's see.
Stanley walked straight ahead through the large door that read Mind Control Facility.
Indeed, because I don't want to. I'm just gonna see what happens if I walk towards escape and then walk back, like he said.
Although this passageway had the word escape written on it, the truth was that at the end of this hall, Stanley would meet his violent death.
Probably.
The door behind him was not shut. Stanley still had every opportunity to turn around and get back on track.
Okay, he's gonna keep walking towards the end. And
at this
then
point,
go
Stanley
back.
Was making a conscious, concerted effort to walk forward and willingly confront his death.
Nope, not anymore. I'm running back. See if he says anything about that, huh? Do you have anything to say about that? Nope, guess he's not saying anything. What do you know, the door?
But of course, Stanley thought better of it and realized he simply had too much to live for.
Okay, that one dialogue, that one little piece of dialogue was most certainly worth it. Okay, so here we have
the lights rose on an enormous
with
room
all
packed
the
with
monitors.
Television screens. What horrible secret did this place hold? Stanley thought to himself. Did he have the strength to find out?
Yeah, he certainly has the strength to find out. Let's press more buttons!
Now the monitors jumped to life, their true nature revealed. Each bore the number of an employee in the building, Stanley's co-workers.
There's still no
the lives of so many
there.
Individuals reduced to images on a screen, and Stanley, one of them, eternally monitored in this place where freedom meant nothing.
Well, we're not monitored anymore. Let's get this elevator.
This mind control facility, it was too horrible to believe. It couldn't be true. Had Stanley really been under someone's control all this time? Was
Come
this
on.
The only reason he was happy with his
Didn't
boring
I just press
job?
That button?
That his emotions
okay.
had been manipulated to accept it blindly?
Here we go.
No. He refused to believe it. He couldn't accept it. His own life in someone else's control? Never. It was unthinkable, wasn't it? Was it even possible? Had he truly spent his entire life utterly blind to the world?
Presumably, yes.
That was the proof, the heart of the operation. Controls labeled with emotions, happy or sad or content, walking, eating, working, all of it monitored and commanded from this very place. And as the cold reality of his past began to sink in, Stanley decided that this machinery would never again exert its terrible power over another human life. For he would dismantle the controls once and for all.
Okay, let's see if I can find anything else that I can do here in this room. There must be something else, another ending or something. Should be able to do something with the with these buttons. Maybe I should count them down. Let's just have a good long look at this room first. I know there's you have the button 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But are there any other buttons? Maybe if I press all those buttons, one of this door will open. There's still an aid button I need to find. I don't know how I'm going to find that. How I should find that. Okay, so I'm not going in this room. Not yet. Not until I have completely ruled out any other choices here. So let's see, let's start with 5 and then go down to 1 and then do the other way around. Maybe with some luck we'll be able to. Oh, that might have been the 8 button on the keypad behind the my boss's desk. That might be for the achievement. Gonna have to try that next time. So next time I'm gonna try to press 8888 on the pad behind my boss's desk. Okay, so 5, 4. Go 4. Let's go after 3 now. So 3 is over here. 3. Nothing happening. So 1, 2. Go for the 3 now. There has to be something that can happen if I press these buttons. 3, 4. There has to be something. Light bulb. 4, and then go 2. Pretty amazing that this is literally only light bulb in this whole facility. Let's see if there's something. If something happens if I press 5. So, did the door open? No, that door didn't open. Can't really do anything over here. There should be something I can do. Console disabled. Maybe I should really press the big button over there and then see if. Let's see, maybe I can do something over here then. I have no idea what could happen if I press those buttons. So yeah, let's just go to the facility power and press the on button instead of the off button, because the off button makes sure I can't ends with me.
And when at last he found the source of the room's power, he knew it was his duty, his obligation, to put an end to this horrible place and to everything it stood for.
And we're gonna turn it on.
Oh, Stanley. You didn't just activate the controls, did you?
Oopsie.
After they kept you enslaved all these years, you go and you try to take control of the machine for yourself. Is that what you wanted? Control? Oh, Stanley, I applaud your effort, I really do. But you need to understand, there's only so much that machine can do. You were supposed to let it go, turn the controls off, and leave. If you want to throw my story off track, you're going to have to do much better than that. I'm afraid you don't have nearly the power you think you do. For example, and I believe you'll find this pertinent, Stanley suddenly realized he had just initiated the network's emergency detonation system.
In that's
the
not good.
This machine is activated without proper DNA identification. Nuclear detonators are set to explode, eliminating the entire complex. How long until detonation then? Let's say 2 minutes.
Oh crap!
This is making things a little more fun, isn't it, Stanley? It's your time to shine.
Oh
you
shit!
You are the star. It's your story now. Shape it to your heart's desires. Oh, this is much better than what I had in mind. What a shame we have so little time left to enjoy it. Mere moments until the bomb goes off. But what precious moments each one of them is.
Okay, either
more
time
to talk about you, about me, where we're going, what all this means. I barely know where to start.
Oh, nope.
What's that? You'd like to know where your co-workers are? A moment of solace before you're obliterated. All right, I'm in a good mood. You're gonna die anyway. I'll tell you exactly what happened to them. I erased them. I turned off the machine. I set you free. Of course, that was merely in this instance of the story. Sometimes when I tell it, I simply let you sit there in your office forever, pushing buttons endlessly and then dying alone. Other times, I let the office sink into the ground, swallowing everyone inside, or I let it burn to a crisp. I have to say this, though. This version of events has been rather amusing. Watching you try to make sense of everything and take back the control wrested away from you, it's quite rich.
Okay.
I almost hate to see it go. But I'm sure whatever I come up with on the next go-around will be even better. My goodness, only 34 seconds left. But I'm enjoying this so much.
Oh, shit.
You know what? To hell with it. I'm going to put some extra time on the clock, why not? These are precious additional seconds, Stan. Time doesn't grow on trees.
Yeah, I can see that.
Oh, dear me, what's the matter, Stanley? Is it that you have no idea where
incorrect?
You're going
what?
Or what you're supposed to be doing right now? Or did you just assume when you saw that timer that something in this room was capable of turning it off? I mean, look at you.
What
running
that?
From button to button, screen to screen, clicking on every little thing in this room. These numbered buttons, no, these colored ones, or maybe this big red button, or this door. Everything, anything, something
okay.
here will save me. Why would you think that,
yes,
Stanley?
Something will save
that
me.
This video game can be beaten? Won? Sold?
Come
you
on, where's that
idea what
pink
your
button?
In this place is?
Pink button with two on it.
Stanley.
Where are you?
You're in for quite a disappointment. But here's a spoiler.
Oh, so this is one.
That timer isn't a catalyst to keep the action moving along. It's just seconds ticking away to your death. You're only still playing instead of watching a cutscene because I want to watch you for every moment that you're powerless. To see you made humble. This is not a challenge. It's a tragedy. You wanted to control this world, that's fine. But I'm going to destroy it first, so you can't. Take a look at the clock, Stanley. That's 30 seconds.
Goodbye, employee.
Left.
What?
Oh,
shit.
Until a big boom and then nothing. No ending here. Just you being blown.
No, this ain't good.
Will
this
you
ain't good.
To your frail life, or will you let it go peacefully? Another choice. Make it count. Or don't. It's all the same to me. All a part of the joke. And believe me, I will be laughing at every second of your inevitable life from the moment we fade in until the moment I say happily ever.
Oh, okay. I died. Well, at least I think I did. Huh. Okay. That one went pretty crappy. So let's try this again, shall we?
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean?
I'm gonna have to try to
Stanley
solve the puzzle a lot quicker. Let's
perhaps
do this.
Simply missed a memo.
Leroy Jenkins.
Stepping into his manager's
okay,
office.
Okay, so now I'm gonna
Stanley
press the 888 button
to discover not an indication of any human life. What could it mean?
Damn it.
Stanley wondered aloud.
Isn't the achievement?
Nobody. He began wildly tearing through papers on the boss's desk, pulling books off the shelf, looking behind paintings, desperate for clues to
yes!
the situation. But his attention was caught by a keypad behind the boss's desk. What could its purpose be? In fact, this keypad guarded the terrible secret that lay buried below his feet. And so the boss had assigned it an extra secret pin. Stanley was in such a rush to get through the story as quickly as possible, he didn't even have a single minute to just let the narrator
talk. My god.
That kind of anxiety isn't healthy. So he relaxed for a few moments with some calming New Age music.
Okay. So this is... Oh my god.
Feeling soothed and rejuvenated, Stanley calmly walked forward into the opened passageway.
My god. I never expected that to happen. Okay, but let's keep progressing in the story. I want to solve that puzzle. And there we go. And there we and there we go and die again. Let's try this again. I'm gonna keep going ahead.
Okay, I think we all know the drill by now. Blah, blah, blah.
What?
Dark secrets, the keypad, Stanley pushes some buttons. Oh, hey, look, it's a new passageway.
What?
Kill surprise.
What? That was pretty awesome. God damn it. Again. And we're gonna try this yet again. Let's move. So is he gonna let me pass easily again?
Here's the door, just go.
this is amazing.
Stanley
God damn it. What? This is new. But let's try this again. Run towards this off button. Come on. Come on. Inevitable life from the moment we fade in. Come on. The moment I say happily ever up. No. Well, the papers are gone, but we're gonna try this again. Let's go. Caramba. And I can't give it a rest. I really want to fix this. I really want to do this. Ah. Nothing I can do here in this room either. Let's try this one more time.
Yet there was not a single person here either.
I know there's not a single
feeling
person
a wave
here.
Of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office.
He closed the room closet. He just closed it off. I can't. My God. That's awesome.
Coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
Anything I can do here? Oh, wait, what? I can't open the bathroom door now. I've got a feeling money's for stealing, but yours, of course, say that's a lovely purse. Well. Huh. Pretty funny that I can actually get into this room now. With this lovely purse. Can't do anything with the toilet though. The more I try stuff, the more secrets I can unlock, the more extras I can unlock. So now the broom closet was closed, and now I can have access to the executive toilet, but there's still nothing else I can do. Time magazine with a clock on it. Let's close this again. Nothing changed? No, okay. Is there... Can I see myself in the mirror? No, I can't see myself in the mirror. Wait, so now it's closed by itself. So if I open it, it closes again when I... Okay. Can I... Oh, I can open this door now. Awesome. Would this be... It's a panda with a gun to his head. Business strategy. Tourism. Okay, please tell me I can open this elevator. Okay, now we're getting somewhere. Okay, this is something else. And now I have to make my own elevator music. How long I am gonna have to stay in this elevator though. Ba-bum, ba-ba-ba-da, ba-bum, ba-ba-da. I can hear something in the background. I think I can hear the narrator talking in the background. There's someone singing along. The narrator is singing along with the music. Okay. Oh, seriously, there's nothing I did. Nothing happened. God damn it. Let's see, can I press the up button? See if something happens if I press the up button. Okay, it seems this elevator doesn't go anywhere. Okay. Come on. Just until the moment open up. Open up. No, not opening up. I'm not ready to give up yet. Let's go again. Nope. Let's see. I have to quit. I almost have to quit. Yeah. Okay. This is it for me. I've had it. I'm just.
All of his co-workers were. Wait,
yes.
No.
Okay, you're repeating
right
yourself
office,
now.
Is this
okay,
office?
I'm gonna quit this, and I'm gonna maybe I'm gonna look it up. Maybe I'm gonna try again next time. But I've had it now. So, thanks for watching, guys. No one has been watching, but thanks for watching anyways. And I'll try again next time, or I'll find the solution online. Screw it.